Hello, everyone. Welcome to the final hour here of Feast or Famine. I figured for a show all about food. Do you guys know you can buy bread that has no crust now?
I saw you tweet about that, actually.
What? That's amazing.
It's called it's called bare bread. It doesn't
they
come.
They just make it bigger and then cut it off.
I don't know. There's no crust on it at all.
No, I reject this. I reject this idea.
We were too focused on whether or not we could and not whether or not we should.
Exactly.
It's the best in the biz. It's the best in the biz.
Oh, my God.
Please, final hour. Let's go. Let's
take all right. Poor sweet Jeff. So inspired. He rushes into this climb. He's so ready to climb up this wall. And you know, he makes it like halfway up before he loses his footing and falls back down.
Cool. Super cool.
It's the strangest thing when he manages to sort of like shake it off and sit back up again. He cannot for the life of him remember his name.
Okay.
Wait, Jeff can't?
Jeff cannot remember his name. Who's Jeff?
Remember that I'm like in this sinkhole?
You remember everything else.
Everything but my name.
You just can't. Who is your deity again?
So my third person character is now the worst.
God, I just can't seem to remember.
I think I need to climb this wall. I feel compelled to do. Let's not roll a two.
Hey, take another crack at it after a couple minutes.
Kill me.
A three.
Wow. Are you trying to level? Is that what the game is?
Oh, yeah, another XP.
Oh, my God.
I think I'm at 5 or 6 XP now. Cool, cool, cool.
So, Jeff, you take another crack at it. You climb back up, and you fall again. You knock yourself clean out.
Okay. All right, I like this.
You are knocked out for a while.
This was, you know the scene in The Sandlot when that kid purposely drowns so that he can have that beautiful lifeguard save him? This is my moment for Ultimate Boss to save me. This is all planned. I fell on purpose. I want you to know that. So I'm looking for, what is it, Windy Peppercorn? Always lotioning,
Windy
oiling.
Peppercorn, yeah. Uh-huh.
That's my ultimate best. All right, I'm knocked out. Let's do it.
Great. Ultimate best, you've made it out of the water. When you look over, you can see that it looks like Cheeto is throwing some kind of food at little green things on his legs. Doesn't seem to be doing much. Bint is just kind of doing some of this. What would you like to do?
All right. Well, I don't know nothing about no knocked out Jeffs or knocked out clerics, but I do see someone attacking their feet. What's going on over there? What do I see?
Ultimate best, they don't have necks. I don't think there's anything you can grab onto. I think I'm just...
That means it's time for the backup plan. I'm going to elbow drop on these slimes.
No, please don't elbow drop my legs. It's
gonna drop right on these slimes.
Oh, God.
Okay, so while you're announcing this, you're shuffling your way over there. and you'd like to try and slam an elbow into one of these slimes?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Give him the flying elbow drop.
All right, so you're gonna jump up and just take a shot, yeah?
Oh yeah.
I'm trying to think of what would you roll for like a finesse of some sort, because it's not that I don't think you can do it. It's that I think there's a possibility you might miss if you're not careful.
Please. Please don't miss.
So would that be dexterity? No.
I think it'd be dexterity, yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah.
Roll plus dexterity. I have faith that you can crush this thing. Just maybe you might crush his foot instead. Let's find out.
Ooh, it's a 9.
It's a 9. All right, great. So, Cheeto, do you see this happen? Do you see, like... him just rolling up to do this?
No.
No.
It comes
okay.
out of nowhere.
You are like so out of it.
Yeah.
Excellent. All right. Ultimate best. You rev up You jump.
I'm always revved up. Yeah.
Always, 100%. You slam an elbow right into that little slime. It splats out, and it doesn't take shape again. So
I hold up my hands, and I see.
Your elbow kind of hurts a little bit.
Well, I'll get that.
It's not an injury. It's just maybe a little too ham for something that was basically liquid.
Any other slimes out there, creepy crawlies that want to come and challenge the beast?
I mean, there is another one of those slimes on his other foot.
Oh, Ultimate, I got on my other foot. I can feel life coming back into me. Please, just elbow drop my foot.
Oh, I didn't realize it was two against one. I rev myself up for another elbow drop.
Okay, great. Roll plus X.
Yeah, well,
okay, so this one, you are so excited five. To kill another one. You are jazzed up, revved up, as always. You jump and slam your elbow down without another thought. Obviously, you're going to nail this again. You don't even need to worry about it. But unfortunately, you slam your elbow right into Cheeto's foot instead.
Ow, my foot! Ah!
Oh, sorry about that one, compadre.
Make it hurt. It hurts. I mean, stop it. Make it stop. I can't even talk.
Ultimate, roll a d4, please.
I'm assuming. Oh,
three.
I'm gonna go run with the cheetahs. I'll see y'all soon.
So, Cheeto, you take 3 damage minus whatever armor
I fall unconscious.
Totally knocked out.
How many hit points did you have, dude?
5. I'm a fucking wizard, man. It's D4 plus 1. It's rough.
No, I know.
Where's your cleric?
That'd be Jeff. Thank you.
Where's your cleric at?
Yeah, he's weird. Where is he?
He didn't come out after me.
He didn't. No. I thought he was going to come out after you.
Oh, I gotta. He's still down there. I gotta go get him.
Wait. I might have one more rope.
All right. Give me that rope. Where did you get the rope from? Did you get it from an adventurer's kit?
Yes, I'm.
Oh, I got one too. I've got that too. Yeah.
You pull a rope.
Also, there's a dead move. So you have a move called Last Breath. You have to tell me whenever to make that, Dodger.
Okay.
Just to keep that in mind.
Right now, you're just knocked out. I'm not gonna make you roll that yet. It really determined. It's going to be determined by how long it takes these yahoos to get your sweet knocked out cleric out of that hole.
Gotcha. All right. I toss a rope into the sinkhole. Okay. I just toss it in there.
Okay. Nothing happens.
I don't know. Nobody grabs onto it.
Nobody grabs it.
Nothing. I jiggle the rope a little bit. Come and get it.
Did you anchor it?
I gotta anchor it.
Well, it's probably not gonna go unless you tie a rock to it.
Oh yeah. Well, I don't know nothing about no science of ropes. I tie a rock onto the end of it, and then I throw it down again.
Okay. There's nothing.
Oh, jeez. All right. Okay. All right. I'm going back down there. Ultimate swan dive into the sinkhole.
I assume that you first take the time to also secure the other end of the rope.
Yes.
Okay. So you secure the other end of the rope to like a bigger rock that you know can hold your weight.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And then you swan dive into the water.
Yeah, with just the ultimate swan dive.
Okay, great. You get down there. You see an unconscious Jeff.
No!
Want to try to bring him out of there?
I want to give him CPR.
Okay, great.
Is there a move? There might be a move for this. Hold on.
Well, there's aid.
It's probably aid.
There is aid.
I'm gonna eat him.
you don't have a bond.
What do I roll?
Oh, he doesn't have a bond with me. I have a bond with him.
But you can still make the roll. You just don't get a modifier.
All right, that's fine.
This is exactly as my fanfic predicted.
Ultimate CPR. What am I rolling?
Flat 2d6,
yeah.
All right. Slash roll 2d6.
Okay.
I die.
You're like, you think you know just how this works.
Pound it on his chest.
You see people like try to do this, but yeah, you like, you're such a strong, just like, you know, you never know how to go less than 100%, right? So you're like mouth to mouth, just blowing so much air into him, just slamming down on his chest. It doesn't seem to be working. You're not quite sure why. If anything, maybe he looks a little worse.
Straight, take some damage.
Yeah, you probably should. Roll a d4 again. Ultimate.
1d4. That's a 3!
3 minus whatever armor you have.
So I just take 1. Okay.
So that doesn't seem to be working. Would you like to just grab him and try to...
I'll fireman's carry him out of the sinkhole.
Okay. Awesome. I have faith in you. Yeah, we're going to call this a strength roll for sure.
All right, here we go.
You know what?
Hey, at least someone can roll strength.
Oh, cream rising to the top.
I want you to describe this. What is it like, this amazing moment when you just like, you pick him up, you climb up, you burst from the water. Like
I don't climb. I fireman's carry him over onto my back, and I crouch down and settle in, and I leap out of the sinkhole, whoosh, out of the top of the water, and land, and whoa, get him off of my back, dust myself. I turn around and point at the sinkhole and I say, not today.
All right. So the team is all back together again. Bint, would you have done anything about that other green monster that was still trying to attach itself to JP's now busted foot?
Would I have done anything?
Yeah. Would you just let it, or during all of this happening?
I mean, and the acid didn't really do much. So.
The acid didn't do anything. What did do something was just a straight up melee attack.
Right. Yes, I would be happy to make a straight up melee attack.
Please do.
Roll
plus strength.
Okay. Let's roll strength.
It's a 7.
Okay. Yeah, you managed to get rid of it. You're like, you falter a little bit because you're not totally sure that this is going to work, but it definitely does. And much like the other one, it just kind of like splats out in a weird, just like weird puddles of green goo that aren't really doing anything anymore. So
awesome.
Yeah, you're good. All right, so you've now got an unconscious, very heavy, very, very muscular.
Yeah, perfect. Sorry. I was gonna make sure you said that. Yeah.
Yeah, you have a very thin, sort of Cheetos coked out wizard. Both of your magic users are down for the count, totally knocked out.
Okay. I'll also say that out of character and out of game, it should be 20 or 19 HP, but we'll just say that because I've been taking all these hits all every time I've taken like a snort of dust, it's taken some HP off. So. So I like the idea of me being dead right now.
Sure.
For the game. All right. For the game.
All right.
So I have an idea, Mr. Best.
Yeah, let's hear it. Let's hear this idea.
Perhaps we can use some of the dust from Cheeto on Jeff to make him come back, and then he can heal Cheeto.
Well, it's a good idea. See, that's why you are the thinking. You got the thinking power up there. See, I'm just the muscle. You got the brain muscle. I'm going to take a little bit of that powder, and I'm going to take a little for myself, you know, just a little on the side there, and then I'm going to take it over to Jeff, and I'm going to give him a little bit of that A little bit of that dust, a little bit of that booger sugar, yeah.
Well, I already took it off of Cheeto, so I hand him like a little one of those folded up papers that has dust in it.
Okay, so you want to use it like smelling salts.
Yeah, that's how you want to put it, yeah.
Okay, great. I would say, yeah, that rouses him. That starts to wake up. Unfortunately, still do not remember your name at all. But you start to wake up.
Then I grab him. Jeff, Cheeto is hurt. We need you to heal him immediately.
Who are you talking to? I don't know. That was ringing no bells.
You're a cleric, are you not?
I'm pretty sure.
That man over there, Cheeto, he needs your help.
I mean, I guess I'll do what I do. I'll do that. I'll go over to him and what is like a healing potion do exactly? Because I have one of those.
I think a healing potion might be like straight up like 1d8 or something.
Oh. Yeah.
Because I chose it instead of the adventuring gear.
Stand by. Heal yourself of 10 damage. Boom.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. So we can just.
I'll just pour that.
Do you have a heal spell?
I do, but like, don't want to burn it right now. And plus.
I got to heal 5 damage. But.
I mean, my heal is 1d8. It could fail.
All right. You're right. Give him the potion.
Yeah, I'll just pour the potion in his mouth.
Give him the potion.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Pour the potion in his mouth. Cheeto. Yeah. You wake up just filled with new energy, and you gain basically all of your HP back, it sounds like.
All right, let me add that in there to the appropriate HP.
And while he's coming up, I actually take, you know, how many stalks of that grass did I have?
I mean, you grabbed as much as you could, right? So some of that is not the right grass at all, but you've got probably like 5 or 6 stalks.
Okay.
Of
I take grass. One out and I hand it to Ultimate Best and I say, here's your ingredient.
Well, thank you, my compadre. As I look at it, is that the right grass? Does it look like the stuff on my note?
Yeah,
oh,
definitely.
Thank you. I put a ultimate hand on her shoulder and I say, thank you. Truly are a great tag team partner.
And I'm just actually laughing because I totally didn't give him the rest of it. And I'm like, yeah, you too.
I trust her implicitly. Ultimate Best is a simple man.
Great. So do you guys want to proceed?
We need one more ingredient, I believe.
One last one before we get the ultimate belt.
Yes.
The world championship belt.
Unnamed cleric, when you walk around, you feel very off. Like, walking is a little difficult. You can't remember your name. Like, you see spots. It's, you are not doing great.
Ultimate Best, you mind giving me some help here? Maybe lending me one of them strong arms of yours?
Anything for you, friend. What do you need?
I just need help walking. I'm a little dizzy. I don't know what happened down there. It's all a blur.
Well, as I remember it, I was climbing out, and you were supposed to come after me, but it never happened.
Yeah, I think I may have grabbed a bad rock, and it just fell right out. I was doing fine, for the record. It was the rock's walls. It was the wall's fault. Like I said... Fart in a weird accent? I don't know why that slipped out. Yeah. It was the wall's fault.
Great. So you guys make your way out of that area on the hunt for this last ingredient, the last thing that you need, feeling pretty confident about the amount of information you can come back with to tell them about what's going on in this cave so that they know, right? Mm-hmm. And you start to make your way into this area.
Hmm. Ooh. Ooh.
It's pretty big.
Kind of looks like a seahorse.
It does.
And it is lit up way near the back by sort of, do you remember that big pile from the bowl root area? That big pile of weird sort of like mining carts and things?
Yeah.
This looks like a much bigger pile like that, but there's light coming from it.
I'm going to investigate that.
Who else needs their... Because I've got mine. We've got Ultimate with his.
I just kind of shakily like bring out my envelope and be like, I need whatever's on here. I am complete. I just need to rest for a bit.
Oh, it's Jeff. Okay. It's Jeff's. Yeah.
It's whose? It's that. Is that me?
Yes. So, you're Jeff. Yes.
So he shows all of you what he has, which you've all seen before, I believe. Which is the Veiled Lady Mushroom is the last ingredient that you're all looking for. There is a little area off to the right. It looks very dark and damp, much like the first area that you went into. But then there's this big cavernous area with the large sort of strange minecart monster.
Perhaps we should check this small alcove. If we don't have to go to the huge cavern, that might be good for us.
I've never shied away from a challenge, but if you think we should check the alcove, all right.
I could just go over there and like rummage through the one to the left, I guess.
You wanna go looking around in here?
Yeah.
That is a very, very large version of one of those holes in the wall. A huge version of that.
Oh.
In fact, before, most of the areas that you've been in, it looked like the walls were kind of rusted away metal with sort of bits of dirt. This area is almost entirely dirt. It almost feels like it's not associated at all with the factory that you've seen before.
Okay. And I tell the team I don't think it's down here, and we're probably going to have to march into the cavern.
Yeah, you know, that's... Sorry, I'm still...
Remember, you do have this over here as well.
All right. This
area. I mean, I'm a little discombobulated right now, so I'm a stick in the big, strong arms of Ultimate Best and just hope he takes me away to the right place.
You're going
to
go far. You're going to go far, kid, if you stick with the Ultimate Best.
Let's see what's to the right.
Yeah, let's explore that right area before we go putting ourselves in danger.
Okay, so as you start to walk deeper into this area, you hear, again, lots of clicking noises. In fact, more than you heard before.
Oh, look at the ground. Are there any holes?
There are holes all over the ground.
Oh, no.
Big ones, tiny ones.
What can we do? What do we have? What do we got?
How big is this area that we're in?
It's very large. It's about this, because you're still like right around here. Yeah, you're like making your way that way.
Yeah.
So this area you're about to go in is just kind of like a wider hallway. But the area where you're seeing all of these holes along the ground is right around in here.
I see.
I want to cast Contact Spirits again.
Okay.
Here's the cast spell roll plus int. A six. Never mind. Six. The spell fizzles. Okay. So I just kind of like spray Cheeto dust and then just wait.
Yeah, much like before when you kind of saw this weird like ethereal root. This time it starts to form, but it becomes very grotesque and turns into a couple of different things and then just vanishes.
So what let's can I discern reality here?
You can. Yeah.
What do I roll for that?
You were going to roll plus wisdom.
Oh yeah. All right. Wisdom.
12.
Jesus Christ.
Okay. You can ask
ultimate wisdom.
You can ask any three of those questions under discern realities.
What are the, hang on, let me find the discern realities question. Defy danger. I can slash, defend, spout, lord. Discern realities. What is about to happen?
You can tell that there are way more of those creatures in here. The same insect creatures that you've seen before, there are a lot of them. There are baby ones, like the first ones you saw. There are also very large ones here. They are very much concentrated in this big. So what is about to happen? If you were to go into that room, you would be overwhelmed, for sure.
Okay, wait a minute. Hang on, okay.
Into the alcove to the right or into the larger cavern?
Into the larger cavern.
Yeah,
where the it seems to be concentrated around where that minecart pile is.
Okay, what here is useful or valuable to me?
Asking that question, you're definitely drawn in this direction. There's something very useful and valuable down this way.
All right, down that way. We didn't. Are there? Is there clicking down there?
You can't tell.
I can't tell. Okay.
It's everywhere right now.
Clicking is everywhere.
My last question is, who's really in control here? And specifically, if we don't go into the big cavern, are we in immediate danger? So if we stay here, I mean, is this a time-sensitive situation?
So when you're asking who's really in control here, you're asking, do you have any control over what's gonna happen right now?
Yeah.
You know that you have a better chance going this way.
Okay.
And going this way.
I'm gonna go that way.
Okay. So you guys would like to try and make your way to the right?
Yeah.
Yep. I'm pretty much at ultimate best swim at this point. Because he's just kind of helping. I have my arm over his shoulder, he has his arm over mine. We're kind of moving together.
Okay, great. You start to make your way that way. You go through this hall. It reminds you a bit of the first hallway that you went through, not quite as tight, but it's still very damp, very muddy. It's kind of on a slope. You might slip up a little bit, but nothing too bad. And you are seeing mushrooms. You're seeing lots of different varieties of mushrooms around.
Mushrooms is what we need.
Mm-hmm. Do any of them look particularly like the picture I have?
You haven't seen anything that necessarily looks like it yet. You are also seeing lots of weird parts of something kind of scattered around. It's almost like the mushrooms are using sort of the cold, dark areas that these machines provide in order to grow. Mm. So right at the end here, right in here, you see a higher concentration of not only the mushrooms, but also of like machinery and parts and things like that.
Everyone knows what we're looking for. Let's find this.
Yeah.
Hey, ultimate best, carry me over to that pile of machinery. Help me out over there. It's got to be there, right?
I carry him over there like a delicate flower. Place him over where he needs to be looking.
Okay.
I'm going to kind of just make my way to kind of the center of that bunch, you know, just to see.
Okay.
What's there?
You want to like look around and kind of like move.
Yeah, kind of rummaging. Around. Yeah, yeah. Move some stuff around. Yeah. Look under things, stuff like that.
You see a mushroom that looks as though it has lace, like white lace, just sort of covering it and draping down to the ground. But it's underneath like a pretty large thing.
Large, what thing?
Like a large piece of machinery. It's mostly wood. It's not going to be too heavy, but it might be hard for you right now.
Ultimate best, you might give me a hand over here. I think I see it under this thing.
Yeah, homie, all I need to do, I need to pick something up, I need to move it, I need to get it out of the way.
Yeah, can you roll plus strength?
Yeah, yeah. Boy. Both of us, I assume?
Yeah.
If you we're lift like together. Good God Almighty.
Oh my God.
That's another three.
The sweet unnamed cleric is just... Oh, yes! Yeah! Another yeah! Fantastic. So,
yes, baby!
So you both start to lift this thing, and it rumbles. It rumbles and almost seems to come to life. It moves on its own, and trains its eyes directly on Jeff and just swats him. So.
I'm going to.
Oh, wait. Yeah, I guess monsters have to also roll moves like hack and slash, right? Like, in order to determine whether or not they
well,
hit?
Well, most of the time, if they fail, they just automatically get a hit.
Say that again?
If Jeff failed whatever his roll is, then he takes harm, and then you just roll their damage against him.
Okay.
All right. Sorry, Jeff.
Hey, it's all good, too.
Two! Rolled bad because he's waking up, you know, he's been sitting there for a while. Yeah, so this thing looks to be made up of all kinds of strange stuff. There are gears and pipes and bits of metal just all over this thing as it sort of starts to come to life and trains its eyes directly on the group. What would you like to do?
So, quick question. Maybe this should have been clarified before, but in my choose your defenses section of my starting gear, can I only choose a chainmail or a shield, or can I choose both? I should be able to choose both, right?
For your starting gear for cleric.
Yeah, it says choose your defenses: chainmail, one armor, worn, one weight, and shield plus one armor, two weight. So I'm wondering if I take zero damage from that, basically.
I think you have to choose one, right?
Yeah, you choose one.
Okay, since we've been using the shield, I'll just say I had the shield. Okay.
So
I'll
take it. Cool. So you take damage from that. Man, this poor sweet cleric that nobody knows the name of is just
taking a goddamn beating.
A really rough time.
Oh, I failed there too. Oh yeah. Another experience. I'm at six.
What about the rest of you? You thought this was just gonna be like rummaging through and grabbing a mushroom, and this thing is towering over the very last ingredient you need.
You know, I could talk to it if you want. We could try
and
to
parlay with it. Reason with this robot.
We should try to reason.
German suplex him into the scrap heap.
All right, I'm gonna reason with him. I'm gonna see if I can get him to, you know, just go easy.
Okay.
So I'm rolling charisma. I'm parlaying with him.
Right.
Here's the roll. Six, god damn it.
Six, okay. So you try to discern like what this thing wants, right? You're like, okay, this is big. Seems a little aggressive, but you're a charismatic gentleman, Cheeto. You think that maybe you know what this guy wants. And so you dig into your pack and reach out some of your Cheeto dust, hoping to maybe connect a little bit with this thing. It leans forward. And then starts to just dig underneath you. So it looks at you, but it's almost like it's looking through you and decides to just start digging into the earth directly underneath you and scooping the earth into its mouth. And so it sort of trips you up a bit. You're like inside of this hole where this giant thing is trying to dig.
I need a little help, guy. It didn't go well. I need some help, please. Someone pull me up.
He's rapidly getting deeper and deeper into this hole because this thing is eating up the earth quickly.
I mean, this may be the worst option based on my rolls, but I do want to go try to pull him out.
You've got to eventually.
You may die, Cheeto.
Unnamed cleric, this is where you shine.
This is the moment. This is the moment I've been waiting for.
This is the moment where you figure out who you are.
Is he like within arm's reach? Like, can I reach my arm down?
I think you would still be able to reach down and grab him, but that window is closing fast.
Yeah, I'm gonna run over there and reach my arm out and try to grab him, and okay. Or like just reach my hand out so he can grab my hand and then pull him up.
Okay, we're gonna call that strength because he's like dropping down fast, and if you're not ready for it, he's gonna pull you with him, right?
Okay. You can
do it. An eight.
An eight.
Eight.
Well, you are successful.
Oh my god. Jesus.
So, oh my god, just you don't know what's going on, but you know that you've had a terrible day and you want to just help your friend. You look at Cheeto and you know that guy's your friend. You run out, you reach out an arm, and Cheeto's able to grab it.
I knew it. I foretold it.
I just bicep curl him up, you know, like the scene in Civil War when Captain America holds the helicopter and landing pad. That's what I do. And I'm just pulling him up just like that, just flexing the whole time.
Unfortunately, you know, you didn't get there quite fast enough that he didn't like get kind of knocked around by this thing. Mm-hmm. And it does continue to sort of try to eat the earth underneath everybody. It makes its way toward Bint and Ultimate. What would you guys like to do?
It's making its way.
Mm-hmm. So imagine that you're on a slope like this. You're all standing along here. This creature came up here and is now digging through the earth this way and eating it.
And we're at the bottom of the slope now?
You are a little bit further down the slope than everybody else was. So it's like nearly to you.
Okay.
Great.
I mean, I'm gonna throw a dagger at it.
You're gonna throw a dagger at it.
What's it made of?
It's made of metal, wood.
And wood? Okay.
All kinds of weird stuff, but it wants to eat. Like that's all it's doing.
Right in the eye.
Wanna try and hit it in the eye?
Wait, yeah. No, that's what I think she should do. I wanna rip its arm off.
I do.
Okay. You wanna try and hit it in the eye? All right. Nope. So are you throwing something at it? Is this a volley?
Yep. Okay.
Great. So roll plus dex then.
Nine.
So you are successful. What is your damage again? A D8?
D8 plus two.
Okay, let's roll D8.
So four.
Okay. So, you throw it's a dagger, right?
Yep.
So you throw this dagger at what appears to be its eyeball. Probably used to be like a light that was on one of these carts or maybe on a helmet that somebody used back in the day, right? And it hits. It makes contact. The glass from it goes everywhere. And this thing screams in a way that sounds like something ripping up metal, that sounds like maybe a trash compactor. It's just, it's awful. It's too loud. And you immediately also hear lots of clicking from behind you.
We need to, I guess I like call to the group. I say, I feel like we need to get behind this thing. If the bugs eat it rather than us, we might be able to make an escape.
He has left, like he's gone down enough of the slope that the mushroom's now exposed, right?
Mushroom is exposed now. You can grab it.
Okay. I think, and that's behind it. So I agree with Ben. We definitely need to let this thing take care of the bugs maybe. And I'm going to go and grab the mushroom behind it.
Okay. So you grab the mushroom. Great.
Yeah.
No problem. No problem at all. You pick it up. Easy peasy.
Cool. It's not screaming. Anything
like that?
It's
not screaming.
Good. Good.
Nothing
fantastic.
Nothing like that. No. So you're able to put that in your bag if you would like to.
I will pop it in my bag.
Okay. It takes you a few tries because you're so dizzy.
I'm so fucked up. Yeah.
Everything hurts. You just want to get out of here, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Would you all like to try and get behind?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So you all like try to sort of climb over it as it's just frantically eating. And as you get around behind it, you turn to look and you just see a wave, just what looks like a wave of not as big of a monster as the one that you saw in that first area with the light, mm-hmm. but They are definitely bigger than the baby ones that you saw from the beginning. They're like teenager ones, we'll say. Just a ton of them just making their way up.
We can just feel how angsty they are. Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, you can feel their angst. Feel the angst, yeah, from them.
Okay. I assume we kind of just see what the machine does. Like, they're on a collision course, right?
So you want to wait? You want to hold?
Yeah, hold.
Yep. Yeah, I hold.
We're holding our ground. I think that's actually a move, but yeah.
So this this monster that's made of all of these different forms of metals and things, it's stopped eating because it's in pain. It hurts. And these insects actually move like right past it. They move right past it, but they stop right after that. They move past it and then almost seem to protect it and snap at you.
Oh, fuck.
You're hearing clicking. You're hearing this rusty screaming of the other monster. There's a cacophony of so many different sounds echoing in this small area right here.
And we're literally like up against a wall, right?
Yeah.
on top of a slope, up against a wall.
How do we want to deal with this?
And we're all the way in the back then?
Mm-hmm. You have space. They're not like right all up on you, but they're choosing to remain closer to this sort of metal rust monster and to move closer to you.
Well, I have that vial of acid left, and that's
about it, right?
Anything. Can we edge around the side of the monster?
You can certainly try.
I'm gonna do that.
You're gonna try to edge around?
Yes. Hey, we don't mean you any harm, bugs. Just want to get out of here.
Okay. So you're. So this whole like thing, right, is happening right here. There's just this big group right here. So you want to try to go from here to sort of edge along the side and see if they'll come at you, right?
Yeah.
So as you try to edge by, these monsters are very interested in what you're wearing.
Yeah.
They start immediately to sort of like take it almost as like a gesture of goodwill. Like, would you like to eat my armor? And they begin frantically eating at what you're wearing.
Oh,
I want to throw my shield to the opposite side of the cavern as ultimate best.
Well, wait, we need to get out.
So
he's on one side of the wall.
Bait is what you're
saying. Yeah, I want to create the ultimate. Like, it's like the largest piece of metal I think we have on us. So I'm ditching it to bait the bugs, hopefully, to not go after ultimate best. And if they do move towards it, I want to run by.
Okay. You would like to try to throw it?
Yeah. Captain America, that shit.
You want somebody else to try to throw it?
No, I want to throw it. I want this. I need this moment. I need it.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Roll strength.
Okay.
Seven. All right. Okay. You rev up for a while. You make yourself a little bit dizzy. You manage to throw it over this whole like weird thing that's happening in front of you. And it lands, and you can tell just kind of from peering down, you can tell it lands like where bugs are already. Mm-hmm. It's not like beyond them really. But yeah, some of them do start to go ahead and eat at that, but definitely a few stay around it. You do notice that it's thinner. It's thinner along there though. Like sort of where Ultimate Best tried to get through.
I'm gonna yell what I've wanted to yell the entire campaign and say, Ultimate Best, take off your armor and your clothes.
Oh, Yeah. I've got to unlatch my arm. Get it off.
Okay. You start taking your armor off?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. What do the rest of you do?
I mean, I'm the only other one with chain, so I'll take mine off too.
Okay, you also want to take your
armor. Now the two buffest dudes.
Rapier.
Yeah.
And toss that as well.
Okay. So you're all choosing to take off, to sacrifice all of your metal items in order to distract these bugs, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
So you can just sort of gingerly get through while they're trying to eat that stuff.
Yeah, that's the plan.
Okay. You toss it all to the ground, right? And the bugs start to eat at it. And if you would like to try to gingerly get out of there.
Yeah, I wanna shimmy along that wall.
Are we all rolling individually?
They're completely distracted. They're completely distracted. Your beautiful bodies glisten as you try to get through there. Those of you who are wearing leather items, you don't get to necessarily, you know, enjoy freeballing quite as much, but that's all right.
I already did earlier. It's all good.
That's true.
All of us are taking our clothes off at some point, except for JP, I think.
Yeah.
So you managed to get out of there, but there are definitely more insects waiting. But it looks like it's a straight shot to try and just run.
I think that's a
great
idea.
It seems.
I think we're all going to run.
Let's just do it.
All right. You run. You make your way down this way. You attract the attention of a lot of insects, some big ones, some small ones. They all start to chase after you. You make your way into this lit up area. You see the corpse of that very first one that you tried so desperately to eat and may never get the chance to actually ingest.
I take a handful of coins and toss it down another hallway.
Okay, that distracts some of them. Yeah, definitely. But this swarm is like trying to come for you, man. You keep on running your way out.
When we out of there. Yeah, at one of these chokes, I think I would probably throw down my last vial.
Okay.
If anything, just, you know, try to stop him or delay him even more.
Sure. Yeah, go for it. There are so many of them that it's not going to distract all of them. It does slow them down just a little bit, though. You make it to the exit. Just two of you looking just so naked and relieved.
So shiny, yeah.
Yeah. The other two feeling pretty good about yourselves, having completed a secret goal between the two of you. And you burst forth into the night air. It is now pitch black outside, but you've managed to make it. You continue to, you know, walk because these insects could just follow you out of there. But you've done it. You've got all of your ingredients. Good job, team.
Yeah, we're the best.
Mission accomplished.
We did it. We're the best. Yeah.
Stormy's very proud of you.
There we go.
Did she kill that monster at the beginning?
She did. That thing is busted.
Go, Stormy.
Huh? Is she waiting there for us?
She is. Yeah, she's outside. She's waiting for you. She is like your, your counselor, so to speak, for the guild. And as you exit, she jumps up like a mother, like just the proudest mom in the world, and she says, "Oh, look at all of you. Are you all right? Are you okay? Oh, were you able to get them?"
We got them all.
I'm so delighted. And she goes and gives each one of you a hug. She unfortunately hugs both Jeff and Ultimate first and has just like lots of kind of leftover weird sweat on her face. As she But she's just blinded by so much joy and happiness at seeing the four of you succeed and can't wait to take you back and welcome you as official members of the Feast Guild.
Wait, Dad.
Yeah. I'm sad that is the only voice that you got to do, Dodger. We didn't get to interact with anything.
So many messages before this game being like, "I can't wait to see all the NPC voices you do." Yeah. And I was like,
bugs too and blobs.
Too much to handle the first time through.
Really, really, the number one enemy is the sinkhole. I mean, I don't think you expected that.
Man, that fricked you guys up big time.
It's true. Jesus. All right, well, let's do some shout outs and call it a show. Wheat, we'll start with you as we always do you're on.
We completed a bond. It was a secret one, but it's had a con going, and the con was to get the grass that Ultimate Best was holding on to because it contained the oils that made any food better. And then after you extracted the oils, you smoked it, and it was a crazy hallucinogen.
Hell yeah.
That is why Cheeto wanted it and I wanted it, and we got what we came for. So good job. Thanks. It's been great. I know I'm just the replacement, but it was great to jump in and had a lot of fun today. As always, Dodger, I thought you did fucking great.
So really? Thank you.
It's not easy. And, you know, like, I hopefully see some more, right? Because practice makes perfect always. So, but you
did a good job, so. Thank you so much.
There you go. Awesome stuff. Pluto, do some shout outs, sir.
Yeah. Thank you again for inviting me on. Similar to Wheat, I was also a replacement, but it was an absolute pleasure to be part of Dodger's first ever DMing experience. I got amnesia. I lost my name. I had some mixed feelings in my belly about, you know, a certain member of our team.
And also from eating poison flowers.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah. I thought it was a lot of fun. Thank chat and thank you guys for being you know, welcoming for someone who has not played a lot of D&D ever. I had a ton of fun with it, and I hope that, you know, maybe Jeff and Ultimate Best and, you know, Cheeto and Bent can all come together again sometime in the future. That'd be super cool.
There you go.
And send me all the fan art possible, because
I
need to be immortalized.
Already some. It's awesome.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's really good stuff for sure. Octopimp, some shout outs. Hey,
what's up? I'm Octo.
That's not his real voice.
I know, right? That's crazy. Guys, what's up? I'm Ultimate Best. I'm Octo. Thanks for having me on. I love doing RP stuff like this. It's always a blast to come up with goofy characters. I came up with Ultimate Best like 45 minutes before we had to do this show. So
nice.
That was real fun. So thanks for having me on. It was a blast. See you guys around.
There you go. And last but not least, I guess for a couple of questions, how'd it go? Are you happy, Dodger? Are you good?
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was so fun. You guys were great. You were very patient with me when I would be like, I don't know what the fuck to do here. So thank you guys for helping me sort of understand Dungeon World a bit better and how to play it. It is super fun. I love that it's just like a big story time conversation. I think it was great. So,
The other question, too, is after every episode of Roleplay, we always have the DM Q&A thread. So,
a Q&A thread? I was actually going to say, I'm totally down to do a Q&A thread.
Yeah, if you want to do one, I'm sure a bunch of people will throw some questions at you. Then Adam's going to obviously have you on and do his report card on the episode.
Right, yeah, we got to do our post-mortem.
Yeah, yeah. So that'll be in like 2 weeks when Adam gets back. So
wait, is that actually where he's going to crit? Well, you could have. This should have
I'm hoping he does. I don't think. Jeff here. Yeah.
But what we talked about doing was me like coming to him with like, I had problems with this, or like this wound up being.
Yeah, that's great.
You know,
that's
like kind of coming to him as a new DM and saying what things sort of tripped me up. And having him give me feedback and stuff. So yeah,
that'd be awesome. Cool. That's great. Yeah.
Well, cool. Do some shout outs, Brooke.
Hi everybody. Thank you so much for watching my very first DMing experience. Thank you to Octo and JP for being on from the get go, and for Brad from filling in for Sam, and Wheat filling in for Michelle. You guys were fantastic. It was such a great, wonderful group to have. If you would like to watch me, I'm on twitch.tv/dexteritybonus, and I stream like 5 days a week. And you can also find me on youtube.com/pretsarttocontinue. I would love to see you there. If not, maybe I'll see you the next time that I'm a guest DM.
There you go. The Q&A thread will be over on my subreddit, I think. Probably just reddit.com/r/itmeJP. Brooke will get that up. And answer all the silly questions that you guys ask every single time. Because it's always the same.
I can't wait.
It's always the same. So there you go. That'll do it for Roleplay Feast Famine. Thanks, everyone, for coming out. Have a good one. We're out.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys. Peace.